I'd like to call this meeting to order. I'd like to welcome everybody here. This time, Chief Carter, if you'd listen, I pledge allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. All right, Pastor, if you'll come lead us in our invocation, please.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we are grateful for this beautiful day, a gift from your hand. And we are grateful that we can meet this night in freedom to do the business of our wonderful town. Gracious God, we ask you to be with our commissioners and our mayor this night in their stewardship of the heritage that you have given to them. And may all their decisions be a blessing not only to our current residents of Wendell, but for generations yet to come. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, sir. Is there any adjustment to the agenda? And no adjustment, need a motion to approve.
So moved.
So a motion, discussion of motion? No discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
The motion carries. Under public comment period, we have one. Sandy, if you'll come up. Mr. Bennett, we have you on the agenda, so we're going to...
I'm Sandy Fouch. I'm the chair of the Appearance Commission, and we just want to kind of like give you guys kudos for trying to help us get this mural up and going. We've been trying since 2012, and I think this year we have really gone very far. We've got a final drawing now. We've got the artists. We've reached out to the East Wake High School. The students there are going to come out and help us be able to do that. I know our fundraising has worked out really good this year, so I really hope you guys will approve it and let us get going with that so we can start concentrating on the next one.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay. Next item is a consent agenda, looking for a motion to approve. Have a motion?
So moved.
Have a motion, discussion that motion? No discussion, all those in favor?
Aye.
The motion carries. Next item is presentation, Mr. Tom Benton. He's our school board member. Mr. Benton, good to have you here tonight, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman and other commission members, and it's my pleasure to be here tonight. I appreciate the invitation to sort of give you an update on what's going on with East Wake High School and with the schools in Eastern Wake County in general. So I'll share a few comments, and then if you want questions, I'll certainly be glad to try to answer those to the best of my ability. One of the main reason why I sought the seat on the Board of Education representing Eastern Wake County is that I wanted to draw attention and focus to the unique needs that we have out here in Eastern Wake County. I'm not a lifelong resident of Zebulon, but I have lived there since 1985, so I've been there for 30 years. I had two daughters who went through the schools out here, graduated from East Wake High School. They're both doing extremely well. One of them is a psychologist in Atlanta. One of them is a media specialist, has a master's from NC State, and works at Fuquay Varina High School. Both of their husbands graduated from East Wake High School. One of them has a degree in marketing from UNCW, and the other has a degree in engineering from NC State. I want to make sure that students who live in our community today and who live here in the future will have the same opportunities for success as that our kids have always had out here. That has been threatened over the past few years through various things that have happened to our community and to our schools. So I have a passion to do everything I can to draw attention on at the board level to our needs out here. So in the past couple of years, there have been three things that have happened. The first one was forming the Knightdale Working Group. It happened in Knightdale before Eastern Wake, this part, because we met with the mayors as a group and we looked at some data and they all decided that we should focus there first. The main piece of data that we were looking at that steered us there first is if you looked at the attendance zones assigned to the four elementary schools in Knightdale, the middle school and the high school, the students who lived in those attendance zones, only 40% of them were going to school in Knightdale. So we said, oh, something's wrong. So we've got that group going. You may have heard some very great, innovative things that are going on at Knightdale High School. So they're a year ahead of us. The board knew when we started that process that we were looking at a model that we could use in other parts of the county who are dealing with the same issues that we are. So it's not just our part, but there are other areas in the county that have some similar type issues. It was decided as soon as Knightdale was up and running and beginning to have the end results of their group to then look at the Eastern Wake part. And the debate was, would we have a Zebulon group and a Wendell group or an Eastern Wake group? And we sought out information from various people, and I think rightfully so, just about everyone recommended that we have a Wendell-Zebulon working group. That group had its first meeting last week. Mr. Perrin was there. Ms. Gray was there. There were about 80 people who had RSVP'd to show up. I think about 60 actually did show up. And I tell you, in my mind, it is the greatest thing that has happened for public education in this area of our county in a long, long, long time. Those were civic leaders, parents, community leaders, business leaders, school people to come together to start working as a group to come up with what we want for our schools out in this area and what will it take to get us there. They had a lot of information that was given out last week. They'll meet every one Wednesday a month for the next 5 months, and then at that time, work will shift to the schools based on recommendations that come from this committee. A part of that move that we took as a board before the working group started was that we consolidated the 4 independent schools at East Wake High back into one school. Now, several people have asked, why are you doing that while at the same time Knightdale is breaking into 4 academies? What's the difference? Well, East Wake took on a process that about 6 schools in the state of North Carolina undertook around 06 and 07, and that was to take a large campus and to break it into 4 independent schools. East Wake is the last surviving one of those because all of them found out that to take an existing school and break it into 4 independent schools caused some real issues. Most of them were management type issues and organizational issues. So it was decided that East Wake High would be put under one principal. That principal was hired last week. I don't know his start date. He is a Wendell resident, Stacy Austin. He served as an assistant principal at Knightdale High back a few years ago. He had coached at Southern Nash High School and has been principal of the Guilford County STEM at North Carolina A&T School for the past 3 years. He was the one that helped start that. His wife teaches at East Wake Middle. And he's got 2 or 3 students that are coming up. I think the oldest one is at Wendell Middle at this time. So he has a lot of knowledge. He has a lot of experience. And once again, he has a commitment to this community to make that school the absolute best that it can be. Once that gets going, I think you'll see a lot of committees set up for the high school, which is separate from the Eastern Wake Working Group that is going along. And so lots of people have had the two movements a little bit confused, and we probably didn't do a good job of explaining the difference in them. But they are really two separate movements with the East Wake High a part of the Eastern Wake Working Group. And I hope I didn't just make that even more confusing. So we're awfully excited. We are seeking input from lots of resources out here. We were tickled to death that we've got 2 of you all that are active participants in it. The meetings are always open to the public. You're welcome to come and observe and see what's going on at all of those meetings. There's tapes made of them if you ever want them. And I'm always available to come out and update you at any time that you have questions or concerns, suggestions, or whatever. So with that, I'll stop and take any questions that you have.
Does the board have questions for Mr. Benton? Mr. Benton, I was going to say thank you so much for taking the time to come and give us an explanation. I know you're extremely busy. And I appreciate allowing us to have 2 representatives from this town to be a part of that group. So we're very appreciative of that. So that being said, everyone here will certainly support this effort as much as possible. Right. And I do appreciate you being here tonight.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Interesting.
All right, next item is an update on 2014 Wendell Wonderland Light Show. Town manager.
Mr. Mayor, members of the board, in 2012, Lake Mara Lights came to the corner of Hollybrook Road and 4th Street, 2012-2013. Last year, Christmas holiday season, 2014, the light show was actually moved to 10 South Cypress. They're in the same area where the Woman's Club is. We also did some lighting in the area around the actual town square. The town did receive a lot of positive feedback regarding the move to South Cypress Street. One of the things that we also added and we tied that in was with the lighting of the square or Evening with Santa, hayrides, carolers, ice carvers, Santa coming to town. It was a very, very big event and very successful. Heard a lot of positive feedback there. The Lake Mara Lights would continue to, they've just expressed their desire to come back for 2015. Mr. Williams is here this evening. Last year, the town did budget for the light show. We, in addition, this year, we've spent about $4,200 on the light show, and it went for about a month and a half. So it was a long period of time. We had some electrical things that we had to do some upgrades to. But Mr. Williams wanted to give you an update on the 2014 show and to express his desire to come back for 2015. Mr. Williams.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor and commissioners. I would like to give you a complete update of a lot of facts and figures that I came up with, which is very amazing. First, I would like to thank the town of Wendell for all your support. I would like to thank Ms. Gina Gray and her husband, Bob, for their donation in providing candy for the children on Santa night when weather permitted, and I want to thank you personally.
My pleasure.
I would also like to thank Mr. Paul White for providing the warehouse space for storage and also for taking it on himself of installing the sound system downtown so that we could enjoy Christmas music as we walk around downtown. I thought that was very, very nice. The new location is absolutely amazing. We were able to bring people downtown. With the new location, I was able to create depth within the display, which I was missing in previous years. I could not create the depth like I really wanted, but we could do it at this new location. With any new location, it's actually an experiment of when you first fire it up. You don't know how it's going to look. And so 2015 season is here, and you haven't seen anything yet. We will be making some changes for the 2015 season. The elements of the display located in the square that was controlled by a computer will be moved back within the main display. This consists of the fireworks display, Santa's sleigh, Santa's train, and the snow machine. Now, there's two reasons why I'm going to do this. Number one, people were constantly asking me, where is the Santa sleigh? Where is the Santa train? Where is the snow machine of all things? I knew that came from the children because they love that snow machine. So what I would like to do, and also another reason, is that we had a problem with the power at the square. It's, we have power, but it's not distributed correctly to run a computerized display. Plus, it took a lot of time in order to bury the cables. You know, people walking through there, you can't leave cables out onto the ground. So we had to bury every cable out there. It took us about 4 days to complete the process, you know, of burying all these cables so no one would trip over it. So what I would like to do, I would like to move these elements. And the only thing that we will need to do where the main display was is just erect a 25-foot telephone pole, which we have. We also have the equipment to put the pole in. And also that will give us the ability to elevate the snow machine for the children. I don't know if any of you have been just sat there and watched them kids when that snow machine come on, but it's like a circus when it comes on. then we'll make these kids happy. 2014 was the best ever in attendance. We had 41 states to sign the guest book, which set a record ever since. We have been keeping records of Lake Mar Christmas since 2007. We also had 18 different countries. Now, this did not set a record. We missed a few. 21 was the record. I am a longtime member of a group of people called TASL here in North Carolina. It's a group of us that actually teach computerized displays and how to set them up. And I've been doing this for quite a number of years. And so I set it out on myself. I said, maybe some of these people in the area would like to have a class. And so I gave a free class to anyone that would like to get involved into such a hobby as this. To my surprise, in the first 2 weeks, it was full. I even talked with people that lived outside of the town that really loved this town and was considering to relocate to the town of Wendell. Business in Wendell jumped forward, as you already know, that McDonald's had a 4% increase in business. The general store also enjoyed an increase in business. On weekends, Agave restaurant was packed. I mean, I have to look at it every night I was there, so I know that for a fact. In fact, a few nights, they were running out the front door. The old saying goes, if you stay open in December more than normal hours, you will reap these rewards. And these are just some of the stories I have heard. We had a direct phone line where people could call and check to see if the display was running on foul weather nights. And also for general information, this line was hot. We would average 30 to 35 phone calls every night. And it was especially hot when the weather was, you know, bad. Wanting to know if we were running the display or not. And as you know, we had a lot of rain in 2014. And so you can imagine how hot that phone call was, or the phone line was. We have to shut the display down because of safety issues, and I know you understand that. And also, it protects our equipment there also. A decorating contest was sponsored for the business and residents of Wendell and could reap rewards if chosen the best in the category. I thought this was absolutely great. Hope to see this is a little bit better defining categories. We have spoken a little bit, the committee has, and we're going to define this a little bit better, and I want to see a lot more people get involved with this. There were some beautiful displays out there. Plus, I saw some displays that was not even in the contest, and so somehow we need to stimulate the residents to get more involved in this. And people's imagination just sometimes blow me away when I see some of these displays. Commissioner Sam, let's remember to turn on the switch.
Yes, this year. I gotta remember that.
Thank you, sir. All these things we're doing are going in the right direction, but we have a long ways to go. Lake Mar Christmas will never charge a fee for people to watch. We work on donations only, and that's the only way we will work. 2014 was a record low. We depend on these donations to bring new elements, replacements of lights, new technology to the display. Let me give you some examples. December the 5th, and I think most of us was there, December the 5th, it was the lighting of the square. I don't know exact head count because everybody was scattered everywhere that particular night. But our donations was $11.87. Another night, we estimated we had about 500 people there. At the end of the show, I collected donations. I had $1. What did I do wrong? This really, really bothered me. Is the show that bad? We won a national award in 2013. I had two good friends that was in video photography and also the ability to use a drone over the display. And they videoed the display. I could hardly believe that my programming skills was that bad. And after reviewing the video, it was not. It was off the chart. In 2015, Lake Mire Christmas was marketed in a different format where we're privately owned and operated and post signs as such. We're going to have more donation boxes so people can see them. I have talked with people at the display that paid as much as $25 to go through a drive-through display per person. I could not hardly believe that. Lake Mire Christmas is just over the top, what people have been telling me. It is the best. I will be investing, again, a lot of money to bring the display new elements and new technology. We will be introducing a huge element within the display that has never been done. Stand by to be amazed. Any suggestions on how we can help the donations grow would be grateful. Our donations is only one-third of what it was when the display was located at Lake Mire Road. Central Baptist Church provided men and women in serving hot chocolate and popcorn at no charge to further their ministry and also provide a donation box. Without them, we could hardly purchase the replacement lights. Above all, what we're doing is stimulating the economy growth of our town, and this is the major reason we wanted to relocate here in Wendell. If you want to see Wendell glow at Christmas, we have got to have community involvement. I have always brought up the town of McAdenville, North Carolina. A lot of times people call it Christmas Town, USA. It has a population of 881 people. The community pulls together. 50% of all the houses are decorated. Volunteers decorate over 800 trees within the town. Their economy impact in the year of 2013 was $11.8 million. Wouldn't it be nice for the town of Wendell? Yes. 2014 was extremely hard on me. I lost my wife in January that year. A lot of our crew was sick, had surgeries during setup time. I took the liberty of tracking how many hours it took to install Lake Mire Christmas. It took 910 hours to actually install Lake Mire Christmas, and that was starting October the 6th to our fire-up date of November the 22nd. I have never missed my fire-up date. I personally had 487 hours, which has almost put me in a hospital. My partner, Mr. Joe Phillips, which had knee replacement, had over 100 hours himself. A friend, which is still in high school, had over 125 hours. Two more friends had over 130 hours. Passage Baptist Church provided help in erecting the 50-foot tree, which in total hours of all the men was 39 hours. The other hours was from a handful of people that came out and helped. I even paid two men $15 an hour to help. Well, after 30 minutes, I had to let them go, and it took me 2 days to straighten out the mess. Well, in plain English, we need help. I have always test-fired the display, and this past year, I ran out of time. The display was up and running on November the 22nd for the first 2 hours, and then disaster hit. I had to shut the display down because we had electrical noise leaking to the data link. After working on it that night and into the morning hours, I was able to locate the problem and the display ran flawless for the rest of the season. This is not your normal display. The display is huge, very complex, still growing, and community involvement and volunteer help is definitely needed. All I need is a list of people willing to help so that I can have the elements on the site. It's not difficult, but it is precise. We will not ask anyone to wire the display. Pulling 14 miles of wire is a huge challenge. Now is the time to get those that will help. We can only do so much, and you can count on me giving 110% because I love Christmas so much. Just come out and sit in a chair and watch the kids. Then you will know why I love Christmas so much. Here is something I would like to see happen. I like to see more lights on trees and bushes as you come into the town of in all directions of Wendell. This will take community involvement. More involvement in residents decorating and enter into decorating contests. Again, community involvement. Help from volunteers in erecting Lake Meyer Christmas. Again, community involvement. Let's keep Wendell Wonderland shining, increase our economic growth. This is the longest running event the town has ever had, and we have a great opportunity here, and I cannot do it by myself. We need help and community involvement. As a side note, I have been approached by a major national TV network that is looking for something like we have. I could not commit because of the time frame, and community involvement is just not there. This will be the key. Now is the time to commit. Time is critical. I have often been asked, when do I start planning and working on the next show? I don't never stop. If anyone would like to help with Lake Meyer Christmas, please send me an email at the address of dwilliams64@nc.rr.com. I hope my inbox is full in 2 weeks. One last thing, and then I'm going to shut up. This past year, I had the display professionally videoed for the first time. A lot of special effects directly from the display and not fake computer-generated images with a lot of drone shots. A DVD has been produced with 5.1 surround sound, and it's my privilege to present a copy to each and every one of you, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Thank you so much. May I approach the bench?
Yes, sir. And let me ask you a question, Mr. Wade. I think it's great, but I don't want it to be a financial burden to you. And I'll tell you where I'm going with this. I think part of the reason that your contribution is so low is from an idealist standpoint, people don't know if it's the town of Wendell's light show under the auspices of Lake Meyer. I think that what I don't want to happen is it to be a financial burden on anyone. Okay,
that's correct.
So I think everyone here has that same sentiment. So what I'm sitting here wrestling with, I heard your presentation is, because I didn't know if you were going to say, you know, I operated a $3,000 loss, whatever, we need this back to sugar. I'm thinking, where my mind was going is, what does it take financially for the light show to go, okay?
Right.
And if we knew what that was, and that was something, since we're doing our budget now, if it's something we thought that was not too staggering that we could actually do, I'd rather us just go ahead and front the money and do it. If anyone wants to give in a donation, the town actually takes it in our coffers. We may make a line item or something for the light show, and we'll have that, what we get through donations, to go in along with a annual allocation. So right. If we get $2,000 in donations, and we're fired, we've got $7,000 next year, we may or may not, but we don't take from it, we just add to.
Right.
And I really have some, I think we all want to be fair with everyone.
Right.
I will say I do see a marketing component where it's good for the town. I don't know. I won't debate you whether these businesses have an increase in sales or not. I'm sure some do. But I think the economic development factor is not seen by how much is spent in the town that night, but it's seen by actually how we market the town when people just come here and see it and leave and say, you know what, I got some things that community I like to see. I'm going to come back. So I see value in it, and I know I'm trying to not, you know, go off track of what you're here for.
Correct.
But I would like to ask you at some point, if the board found this, if you could maybe get with our town staff to find out how financially how did the light show do? What did it cost? How much training was it? what does it take to operate? I know the town actually did help with some cost, and it does help some cost.
Yes.
We may be covered, we may not be. And when you mentioned the actual more lights and things, and I don't disagree with you, but we have a limited town staff, and some of that community involvement is going to be our actual town staff. And in my mind, it's going to be all Alton and them can do to actually, maybe if we decide to help them assist you with that small space you got now, much less trying to decorate other parts of the entrance of the town. I mean, I'm kind of being blunt, but I'm just being honest.
Oh, yes.
So that being said, if any of the boards have some questions, but I would like for you to, I don't think you necessarily have to make another presentation to us, but I would like for you to give information to Teresa so she can actually bring it up in another board meeting and put on our agenda and tell us, you know, financially, where was it at? Do we need the help? Do we not? I'm not trying to get in your business, but I want to make sure it stays successful. Does that make sense?
Yes, makes a lot of sense. It really does.
All right, you can approach.
Okay.
So, Teresa, just at some point, it don't have to be done like yesterday, but at some point, y'all get together and find out. We may be contributing enough, we may not be. Just find out where it's at. And since we got these budget talks, if we're all going to do something, we need to know now.
Now's a good time. Yes, I agree.
Thank you. Appreciate it, by the way.
Thanks, Don.
And I really did like the location this year as well. And you did do a good job, Mr. Weeds. We really do. I think the entire town appreciates your efforts, seriously.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Next item is review and discussion proposed mural to be located at 100 West 3rd Street. Patrick.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of the board. Tonight, the board is asked to review and discuss the Appearance Commission's recommendation regarding a mural application. At the February 2nd, 2015 meeting, the Appearance Commission reviewed the application that they actually are sponsoring and voted 5-0 to approve it on the side of 100 West 3rd Street, which is Farley's Accounting and Tax Service. Back in 2013, as part of the long-range work plan for the Appearance Commission, they set a goal of having murals painted in the downtown area of Wendell. Based on that desire to have murals, they stepped up to the plate and decided that they wanted to sponsor one of the first ones to try to gauge more interest in it. They, with staff's help, proposed text amendment that the board approved. So they started work after that. They worked on raising funds to support their own mural. They held an online community survey that to kind of gauge what type of themes the town citizens would like to see. They saw historic Wendell, tobacco and farming, and trains. At the December 3rd meeting, they voted on the highest priority as the 100 West 3rd Street for their location. At August 4th, 2014 meeting, Peggy Lee Mead, a professional muralist from Wendell, who most of you probably know, offered to design the mural free of charge for the Appearance Commission. She also offered to outline the mural on the wall, and if we could get volunteers to help paint the mural. Six art students and their teacher from East Wake High School have agreed to help paint the mural over evenings and weekends this late spring, early summer of the year. Appearance Commission members will also be helping assist with the students and the teacher. The mural consists of a train at the Wendell Depot and citizens from the time period around Wendell's incorporation in 1903. Over the course of the past 2 years, the commission has held fundraisers. To date, they've raised just almost $1,450. All that money's been raised by private individual or donated by private individuals. That money is expected to cover the cost of the paint, brushes, and other materials as needed. Ben Carroll, who owns Old Oak Construction, is a member of the Appearance Commission, is loaning out some scaffolding to help paint the murals, as well as some other supplies. So here's just some works of what Peggy has done elsewhere around the community. The one in the bottom right is at the Amish Market, which will be opening up sometime soon. And that's what the mural would look like.
All right, Patrick, so I can interject for the board. This is actually a line item for discussion only. It will have to actually be voted on at our next meeting, which is actually where we have action. So it's like I got a complete recommendation. I'm going to look for a nod ahead that the board is all in favor of it. I'm going to ask that it be put on the consent agenda for our next meeting. Is the board fine with that? I'm just looking for a nod ahead.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
If you just tell me, you just put it on the consent agenda at our next meeting.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Next item is Commissioner comments. Commissioner Grove, you start it off for us. Do you mind?
I will.
Since our last meeting, I attended a meeting here in Wendell regarding cell towers. That's a big, hot topic of conversation. And the good news is, coming out of that meeting, the Wendell Historical Society and the State Historic Preservation Office have come to an agreement about what they're going to require for the cell tower over on 4th. And we went from famine to feast, because it's looking like there's just getting ready to be cell towers everywhere. So we're going to have hopefully one up here midsummer, one back behind us, one out further and close to Sheets and so forth. So those of you who've been anxious and having problems with your cell service, we're getting ready hopefully to get all that taken care of. The next thing that I did was, as Mr. Benton said, Commissioner Parham and I were at the Eastern Wake Schools work group at East Wake High School. They had a very thorough PowerPoint that they showed for us. And I actually kept a copy of it, which I don't think I was supposed to. So I'm going to take it back when I go back next time. And I made a copy for all of y'all. But my first impressions when I was just flabbergasted, I'll be honest. And it demonstrated to me something that I think we've all known, is that we definitely needed some light shined on our schools here, some more than others. And it was just painfully true. It's no way to sugarcoat it. The good news is everybody there is ready to, and the school board members were present. This isn't just a group in name only. This is a real action group of folks, and I really think something great's going to come out of it. This same process was used in Knightdale, and they are heading in a positive direction, and so I'm really looking forward to the great things that are going to happen at East Wake High School now. I really am, and just our schools here. I think we need, I think in some instances we probably have some unique needs, but then in others, if you look at the statistics, our needs aren't any more unique than other places that are enjoying more success. There's got to be a reason why, and I think that's what we're here to address. If it's resources or whatever, we need to figure out what it is and make it happen here. I'm tired of Wendell getting what's left over at the end of the day. So anyhow, and the last thing on that note, I wanted to welcome Stacy Austin. He's the new principal at East Wake High School. Ever since that was announced and in the paper a few days ago, I've heard just so many people have stopped me that know him and know his wife or whatnot, and people are just very excited. So again, I'm really looking forward to the positive growth that I anticipate is going to happen out there at East Wake High School, and I look forward to being part of it. One more thing I want to mention, Mr. Williams and I met, I don't know, a month and a half or 2 months ago, and we talked about the Christmas light show, and he expressed his concerns about the financing of it with me and the need for just some help and some volunteers. And I told him that I was going to start twisting arms and doing the best I could to get some folks to help him. So if you can't just go out there for 2 hours, it's not that kind of a situation. But if this is something that you are interested in, not necessarily Christmas lights, but electricity, electrical things, and doing things like that. I know it is not my cup of tea, but I know that there are people who enjoy that, and I really hope that you'll take an interest in it, because it's a great thing for our community. We have spent some money in this past year out there at the town square, but that money, yes, it did benefit the light show, but we have a lot of events out there. So we've benefited the Harvest Festival and the Food Festival and any other weddings. There are weddings out there. There's all kinds of things that happen out there. So we did some electrical upgrades that we needed to do, and it was for everyone's benefit that we did those. But anyhow, so they helped him, but he needs more help. He needs some more help than that. We also discussed his donation boxes and where he has them located out there, and the image he's creating. Why are people not understanding, and why did they used to and don't now? And why it seems like it's been in a steady decline. So hopefully with our conversation and him speaking here tonight and the fact that we're all have become aware of it, things will look up for him. And if you're looking for something to do in October, I know he'd love the help. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Commissioner Boyette.
I was speaking with a couple who is in the process of moving to Wendell. And I always like to ask people when they're moving to Wendell, you know, what attracted you to Wendell? And I heard a reason that was not expecting. They said they were moving to Wendell for the schools. And I said, excuse me? And they said, we're moving to Wendell for the schools. And I said, why is that? I went to Old Carver. I went to Wendell Elementary. I went to East Wake Middle, and I graduated from East Wake High. And I think it was a great educational experience. This is a family that is currently living in North Raleigh, and they're moving to Wendell for the schools. I said, why? And they said, because by the time their kids get old enough to get into school, there's going to be caps. Wake County is having issues with the growth. They're having to put caps on schools, and it's creating uncertainty in where parents are going to be able to, you know, get their kids into schools at. And Wendell, if you go into the schools and you talk to the parents, I think a lot of the parents think very highly of the schools. And I think some of the negative things that are said about the schools is maybe in comparison to some other areas, but, you know, if you buy a house in Cary, you'd be lucky to go to school within 20 miles of where your house is because of the caps and the overcrowding and things like that. And that sort of stability is one thing that we do have going for us here in Wendell. So I just thought I'd like to share that. It was surprising to hear that given as a reason, but I think it's very valid. And to completely change the subject, I've said it before, and I'll say it again. How about that Wolfpack?
Thank you, sir. Mayor Pro Tem Pair.
Yeah. Commissioner Boyette, those that family you talked to called futurists. They know what's coming down the road, so they are preparing for it. I'd like to talk about three quick things. Talking about our schools, one thing that I know really makes a difference in schools are, you know, the parental involvement that we have in our schools. That is the biggest, most important thing we can have. As I said, the schools in the West, when I was out in that direction, you know, those parents were there working with small groups, one-on-one, and that makes the difference because we know that our kids learn at different rates, and sometimes they're left behind. You know, the teachers will teach to the one who's always raising the hand, popping the hands up, and forget about the others. In Eastern Wake, we've started a 55-plus initiative with the county. The fastest growing population of people in our county, especially in the East, 55 plus. A lot of those people don't have transportation to get to the stores, hospitals, just shopping. So we are in the process. And while I thought it was going to be an easy process because my church volunteered their vans, too much reliability. So we met with Don at Eastern Wake Human Services, and we're going in another direction. We're actually trying to get volunteers here in the East. You'll be hearing more about that. And the senior citizens that here in our town, there are some needs, some general needs. And when our manager told me about some of those things, I went down, and sure enough, some of the rooms needed painting. And at Eastern Regional Center, there is a gentleman there who has a small population of young people who volunteer to do things. So I talked with him, and he went over to talk with that director. So he and his crew are going to do the painting for the Eastern Regional Center, for the senior citizens.
Thank you, sir. Commissioner Luce.
Thank you, Mayor. I just wanted to comment. Saturday was a great day in the town. Kudos to Jeff and Teresa and Chief Carter and Alton and everybody who kind of helped to pull their staff together. I thought the bike festival went off very well. It was nice to see people walking around with food trucks and just a different kind of excitement. If you didn't watch the kids ride the bikes in the clinics afterwards, that was one of the most entertaining things, watching these kids on the bikes after seeing the pros hit these jumps and see these little kids who were, I mean, 4 or 5 years old and just ripping and rocking. It was awesome. So that was a great event. I just encourage citizens to stay, you know, in tune to the events that we have going on. This is kind of the start of our exciting season with festivals and events and downtown events. So, you know, on the weekends when it's nice and get out and walk around and explore some. I'd also like to encourage any citizens who are interested. We're starting to accept applications for citizens' boards. So there's a lot of different ways to serve, and we all have our own talents and our own special interests. And I'd encourage everybody just to pursue that if something that's interests you or somebody you know who'd be good in that area as well, too. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Commissioner Lockwood.
Thanks, Tim. I'm excited. I'm excited about this town. I'm excited about what's going on, the different events we have, the signs we've gotten up. I'm excited about this board. Everybody moving in the same direction, a lot of agreement, a lot of forward thinking, putting up Wi-Fi, the capability of possibly having some fiber here local, some new shops that are opening downtown. So I'm excited. I'm very positive. I know we've had over the last 4 or 5 years some real negativity in a lot of areas, and I think right now we're at a spot where the potential is just extraordinary for this town with our parks and rec, the different things we have going on downtown, the light show, the mural that's going up. I just think it's an exciting time for Wendell, and I'm really looking forward to the next couple of years and working with this board.
Thank you, sir. Commissioner Lutz actually got part of my thunder. Like him, I just wanted to express again as far as the town staff. I know like the event we did have Saturday on the bike show and all, it takes a tremendous amount of staff working other than a regular 8-to-5 Monday through Friday. And if I call that one department, I might miss one. But I will say that our town, the citizens look at the town not as the commissioners, the mayor, they look at the town as the town staff, because that is who they see who's actually doing the work for them, whether you're in their yard or whether you're actually, you know, beside on a roadside somewhere or whether you're at Parks and Rec. The citizens equate the town of Wendell to the staff and the quality of service that they do. And I want to say as the mayor, on behalf of me and this board, how much we appreciate the quality of the employees that we have and the quality of customer service that this town staff gives constantly. It very much makes it very easy to actually be able to go out and be ambassadors for our town. With that being said, we are adjourned by affirmation.
Power whenever gets it, it's on there.